What the Twilite Zone is basically the time, mood, or pitch between what is abstract and what is concrete. I alluded to that because you can, okay, you got house, let's say that's abstract, and then you got hip hop, let's say that's concrete. I was right in between both of them. Twilite Tone is the mood, pitch, and sound of the Twilite Zone. I am the Twilite Tone, and what brings me here is to learn Ableton inside and out. I came up with a diverse background in music. In the 80s, I was fortunate enough to be exposed to so-called deep house music. And we grew up with people like Ron Hardy, of course Frankie Knuckles, Andre Hatchett, Lil Louis. But on the other side, we got to hear the gamut of underground hip-hop, stuff like Schoolie D, all the way to Divine Force, Sir Ibu, Ultramagnetic.
Fresh like air, well dressed, yes the LS is here. I appear on peers with my peers, the imperial like margarine. I'm butter, yes fly like my Leia. I get
my fake Gucci, it's about that time. It's time for some percolator. I circulate around the block, to give me a six pack to half a Harold's chicken. A good combination. When I get bubbly, I do it in moderation.
What I'm most proud about as far as production is Chapter 13 from the Resurrection album. When I made it, I thought I was dope, you know, but hearing it out loud, I realized, like, man, I didn't have hi-hats in the song, and that wasn't really done like that. And the way I chopped the kick and snare, and I used the Detroit Emerald drums way back then. And then just listening to me rhyme, I was just like, man, it really inspired me. And something like Ableton really inspires me because not only am I able to be creative and intuitive, but I'm also able to present it, record with it, perform with it live. It seems like it has no limits once you learn it, and that's why I'm here today.
We're just gonna do the little warpology 101 lesson. We're gonna learn to warp here with an old Beatnuts tune off the books, and I'm just gonna drop and drag the track right into the first audio clip slot over in Ableton. You double click on the name of the clip. That's gonna show it up down below in the clip detail view. Now I'm gonna zoom on in at the beginning of this tune. If I play right now, get that pause, and then the beat comes in. This little flag is at the very beginning of the track. This flag is called the playback start marker. I'm gonna put my mouse directly on top of that play start marker, and my mouse will turn into a black diamond when it's lined up. Click and drag to your right, and you can then go and line it up with wherever the one is supposed to be. Now when I play the clip, it starts right on the kick. So I'm gonna take my mouse and I'm gonna put it right on top of that start marker one more time. And now I'm gonna right click with my mouse. The first thing I'm gonna choose is the second one from the top, the one that says set 111 here. This way we're telling, okay, here's the one, the first beat of the first bar. Our warping's off right now, and you see seconds underneath and there's nothing above. The warping automatically got kicked on. We lost the seconds display, and now we have bars and beats display on top. Wow. Not only that, we see these little yellow markers. That's what warp markers look like.
Okay.
Now, when you warp a song, there's always gonna be a minimum of one warp marker at the very beginning, and then Ableton will add additional warp markers wherever it felt the tempo was drifting and it was attempting to put it back. This one's pretty clean because it was done with a drum machine. When I zoom out to look at the whole song, you can see there's really just some warp markers at the very beginning and the rest of the tune is even. If this was some Motown stuff that was done with no click track, you would just see yellow the whole way across. So the last step, just put your mouse back on that play start marker one last time.
Right
click, and we're gonna choose this option here, warp from here.
Oh, okay.
Now that it knows where the one is, it reanalyzes and it got rid of some unneeded warp markers and everything just snapped just a hair and now it's nice and tight. If I play it against the click track, it should be dead on. So I'll turn my click track on, hit play. Sounds good. If I need to play it faster or slower, all I have to do is change the tempo here. Slow it down. A warp mode is an algorithm they programmed to optimize the sound quality for different types of sounds you might be putting in. The default warp mode in Ableton when you first install it is a very simple one called beats mode. And beats mode sounds really good if it was just a kick, snare, and hi-hat. But when you start to add the rest of the instruments in a mix and you need to change the tempo, it starts to sound pretty weird. It sounds totally normal at 100 beats per minute. Sounds fine, sounds just like it did in iTunes. You'll really notice a difference in the sound quality when you start to slow it down more than about 10 beats per minute. It starts to get real jumpy and nervous sound. It's like all skittery, listen to this. Gets this real kind of jumbled, skipping sound. You slow it down all the way and the computer freaks out on the sound. You get this weird stutter edit thing. You know, so you could actually use that as an effect. Instead of using beats mode, Complex and Complex Pro will sound way better even when you do 15 beat per minute tempo change. And it's just steady. And then check this out. If you did want to have that old school sampler or like vinyl type sound, they got this mode called Repitch. At 100, it sounds normal, but because it's in repitch, if I go up, it's gonna sound like we got a 33 on 45. Do the chop and screw. You know? There's two other modes in here. There's one called Tones and Texture. Tones is one that works really good if you had a little piece of a record where it was any kind of a solo instrument playing a melody. Maybe you had like a Miles Davis trumpet, or even if you had a singer that sent you an acapella and you're gonna do some time shifting and things. Texture is really good when you have a bunch of instruments playing together, but usually no drums behind it. The sound of whatever, the Boston Philharmonic, 70 strings, it's all layered sounds like that. Usually by default, when I'm doing production work, I'll either keep it in Complex or Complex Pro, and then if I have a more specialized sound, I'll try one of those other ones out. Guys like him that have been doing music production for so long that are already thinking music, he already knows what he needs to do.
It's insanity on crack. Ableton is insanity on crack. That's the new tackle. I want my money, Ableton. I want it. The fact that it's on a computer and it's on my laptop, I can be in a hotel room. That's one of my goals this year, is to be able to create, quote unquote, on the fly. I think Dubspot is a great place. You know, before it used to be, you had to call your friend and you just learn off of bumping heads. Now you have a place dedicated to instruction and you know, being informative, and you can ask questions to a guy who's not necessarily like this college professor type, this guy that's actually in the trenches and he's of it. Dubspot is the place to be.
Welcome to Dubspot. We believe in providing you hands-on experience right away. Whether you're completely new to music and want to turn the sounds in your head into a musical reality, or you're an experienced artist looking to refine your skills and add new tools to your arsenal, we're ready to meet you at your level. For students of all ages, all levels, and all styles of music, Dubspot is here to help you achieve your goals. With course offerings both online wherever you are and at our school in the heart of New York City, we are ready to guide you through the next phase of your musical transformation. Whether you want to produce music, DJ, or do both, you've come to the right place. Come explore Dubspot for yourself. Become a part of our community and make music.